إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، إخوتي في الله، all praise is due to Allah. We praise Him a praise suitable for His greatness and His supremacy and His loftiness, and we thank Him for the countless favors He has bestowed upon us. إخوتي في الله، يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. As for the favors of your Lord, then mention them, speak about them. ويقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى: فاذكروا آلاء الله لعلكم تفلحون. Mention the ala of Allah, mention the ni'mas of Allah, mention the favors of Allah, لعلكم تفلحون. Perhaps you might be successful. ويقول نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم: والكلمة الطيبة صدقة. And a good statement is charity. إخوتي في الله. Today we want to talk about the importance of good speech, positive speech, and staying away from negative speech. فقد جاء في الصحيحين من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. Whoever believes in Allah and the last day, let him speak well or be quiet. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He took a mithaq, al-ahd, a contract from Bani Israel that they speak good. Contract with Allah. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ لَا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ Husna. And we took a contract from the children of Israel that they don't worship anything other than Allah, and that they're dutiful to their parents, and that they feed their relatives, and that they feed the poor, and that they only say good to people, that they say good statements to people. نعم يا إخوتي في الله، هذا أمرنا اليوم. لا بد من كلمات الطيبات. You have to have good speech at all times. إخوتي في الله، جاء من حديث أنس عند الإمام أحمد أن الرسول قال: يا محمد، أنت خيرنا وابن خيرنا، سيدنا وابن سيدنا. قال: قولوا بقولكم ولا يستهوينكم الشيطان أو لا يجرمنكم الشياطين. أنا محمد عبد الله، لا أحب أن ترفعوني فوق المنزلة الذي أنزلني الله. نعم يا إخوتي في الله. A man came to the Messenger of Allah and said, Oh Muhammad, you're the best of us. You're the son of the best of us. You're our leader and our master. You're the son of our leader and our master. The Prophet said, Say what you're saying, but don't be used by shaitan. Don't have shaitan beautify your speech. I am Muhammad Abdullah, the servant of Allah. I don't like that you raise me up above the position that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put me in. وجاء في الصحيح من حديث أنس بن من حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت: استأذن رهط من اليهود على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقالوا: السلام عليكم. قالت: عليكم السلام واللعنة. قالت يا عائشة: إن الله رفيق يحب الرفقة في الأمر كله، يحب الرفقة في الأمر كله. قال: أولم تسمع ما قالوا؟ قال: قلت وعليكم. قلت وعليكم. The Jews, they came to the Prophet's house sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when they entered upon him, they said assalamu alaykum. They didn't say assalam. Assalamu alaykum, death be upon you. Aisha said, let death be upon you and the curse of Allah be upon you. Prophet said, ya Aisha, really Allahu Rafiq, Allah is soft. He likes softness and gentleness in every situation, even if it's evil, no matter what the situation is. Allah likes gentleness and softness all the time. قالت أولم تسمع ما قالوا. Did you hear what they say? The Prophet said, and I said, wa alaykum. I said, the like to you. And the same be back to you. نعم يا إخوتي في الله. ويقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع والنقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. We're going to indeed, we're going to test you with something from fear and hunger and poverty and the loss of fruits of this world. Give glad tidings to the patient. وبشر الصابرين. Give glad tidings to the patient. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he describes them. الذين إذا صابتهم مصيبة قالوا قالوا. نعم هذا من الصبر. الكلمة طيبة من الصبر. نعم. Those when they are afflicted with a calamity, with a hardship, they say, before we look at what they say, this is the description of the patient. Being patient means to say something طيب. Don't go, oh man, why this had to happen? Oh man, it's going to be bad. قالوا إن لله وإن إليه راجعون. أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. Those when affliction, those when affliction afflicts them and the calamity befalls them, they say, to Allah we belong and to His we are returned. إن لله افهم ما تقول. Understand what you're saying. إن لله, I'm the property of Allah. I belong to Allah. Whatever I have, it came from Him. He has every right to take it back. Meta sha'a, kaifa sha'a. Whenever He wants to take it back, however He takes it back. My eyes are from Allah. My mother is from Allah. My house is from Allah. My car is from Allah. Whatever He has, inna lillah, ana mamluk. I'm owned by Allah. I'm the property of Allah. He has every right to take everything back. وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. We're going to go back to him. And he's going to ask me about this day right here. He's going to ask me about this ni'mah. وَأَنَا شَاكِرٌ. And I'm patient. And I'm appreciative of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قُلْ أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. Those are the ones Allah mentions them good. By their name. وَرَحْمَةٌ. And the mercy of them. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. Those are the ones that are guided doing hardships. You have hardships in your life. You have calamities. You have difficulties. You're not the only one. You're not the only one that has hardships. But you must be guided. You have to have a kalima tayyiba. You have to say something good. Mahma kana al-amr. No matter how hard the situation is. قُلْ قَيْرْ يَا إِخْوَتِي فِي اللَّهِ هُنَّكَ مَنْ هُوَ أَتْقَى لِلَّهِ مِنْكَ وَأَصْلَحْ قَدْ أُبْتُلِيَ بِأَشْهَدْ مِنْكَ فَاصْبِرْ وَقُلْ الْخَيْرْ. There are people better than you, more righteous than you, and they have been tested and afflicted with things worse than you. Say good. Say something tayyib. Say something worthy. نعم يا إخوتي في الله. جاء من حديث أم سلمة في صحيح مسلم أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ما من مسلم يصيبه مصيبة ما من مسلم تصيبه مصيبة فيقول كما أمر الله إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. اللهم أجرني في مصيبتي وأخلفني خيرا منها إلا أخلفه الله خيرا منها. There is no believer, he falls into a calamity, a hardship. So he says like Allah commanded him to say, إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. اللهم أجرني في مصيبتي. Allah reward me for this calamity. وأخلفني خيرا منها. And replace it with that which is better. Nobody says that except that Allah replaces what is better. Salama قالت لما مات أبو سلمة. Her husband, لما مات أبو سلمة قلت أي المسلمين خير من أبي سلمة. What man, who of the Muslims is better than Abu Salama? Who's better than my husband? She couldn't picture anybody better than her husband. أول بيت هاجر في سبيل الله. It's the first family that ever they made hijra to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال ولكني قلته. He said, but I said it. إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون. اللهم أخلف اللهم أجرني في مصيبتي وأخلفني خيرا منها. قال فأخلفني الله رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I said it and Allah replaced my husband with the messenger of Allah. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم married her. نعم يا إخوتي في الله فقولوا خيرا نرجو من الله خيرا. Say good and we expect Allah from good. We expect good from Allah. When the نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول كما جاء من حديث أبي هريرة المؤمن القوي خير وأحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف وفي كل خير. The strong believer, not the strong man. The strong believer is iman is strong. The strong believer is better and more beloved than a weak believer. And in all of them is good. ثم بين النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then the Prophet explained why the strong believer is strong and is better. احرص على ما ينفعك واستعن بالله. Be anxious on that which benefits you. واستعن بالله and seek Allah's help. ولا تعجز. Don't be incapable. Don't say I can't do it. I don't know. I just get upset. This is the way I am. قال وإن أصابك شيء. If something afflicts you. وإن أصابك شيء لا تقول لو فعلت كذا كان كذا وكذا ولكن قول قدر الله ما شاء فعل فإن لو يفتح عمل الشيطان. If something afflicts you, a calamity befalls you. Don't say, if I had done this, it wouldn't happen. If I had done this, if I went that way, if I would have stayed home, if I did this, if I did that, it would have happened this way. Don't say that. Say, قدر الله. This is what Allah decreed. قدر الله. أي الله علمه كتبه شاءه أوجده. Allah decreed this. I mean, Allah knew what was going to happen. He wrote it down that it happened. He willed for it to happen, caused it to happen. فَإِنَّ اللَّوْ يَفْتَحْ عَمُلُ الشَّيْطَانِ. Low, if you say if, and if it opens the door of shaitan, you always will be regretful. Your whole life, if I only went back home. If your whole life, if I only just went back home. Your whole life, you remain regretful. لا تفتح عمل الشيطان. Don't open the door of shaitan. Just say, قدر الله ما شاء فعل. This is what Allah decreed. He does it as he wills. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى السلام والعافية. We ask Allah for his tranquility and his protection. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا في إخوتي في الله. لا بد من الكلمة الطيبة في أضيق الأحوال. You have to say a good statement, a nice statement, no matter how hard the situation is. يدل على حسن ظنك بالله. It shows that you have confidence and true trust of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. فلذلك علمنا نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كما جاء من حديث أنس أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا عدوى ولا طيرة يعجبني الفعل الكلمة الطيبة الكلمة الحسنة. The Prophet said لا عدوى. Sicknesses don't just go from one person contagiously to another. لا, that's from Allah. When you got sick, that's from Allah. It's by the decree of Allah. Not because you went over there, not because you visited Fulan, not because you know. That's from Allah. لا عدوى ولا طيرة. الطيرة هو أن يتشائم بالشيء. That you see something, you feel bad about it. Oh, when I saw him coming, I'm not going to go now. I'm not going to get married now. I'm not going to do that now because I saw that. لا. لا طيرة. Don't have bad luck. Don't feel bad luck. Don't feel bad about anything. Put your trust in Allah. ولكن يعجبني الفعل. The Prophet said, but I prefer to be optimistic. They said, what is optimistic? To say a good statement. To say a wholesome statement. جاء من حديث أبي هريرة مثله النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا طيرة خيرها الفعل. قالوا ما الفعل؟ قال الكلمة الصالحة يسمعها أحدكم. The Prophet said لا طيرة. لا طيرة لا تتشائم بالشيء. Don't see something and it's going to make you stop what you're going to do. Don't hear something, say no, I'm not going to do it now because I heard that. Because keep on going. But say something good. نعم. Say, La'allallah yul khayr. Perhaps Allah is going to protect me. Perhaps Allah is going to put barakah in it. نعم. They said, what is al-fa'al? It's optimism. You say there's a good statement one of you hears from your brother. A good statement that you hear. إخوتي في الله وجاء من قول ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه قال أطيرة شرك وما منا إلا ولكن الله يذهبه بالتوكل. There's no tiara. There's no bad luck. But there's nobody except us that he feels bad about things. Nobody except that he wants to do something he feels bad. But Allah takes it away with tawakkul. Allah moves that stuff from his heart by saying something good. إخوتي في الله جاء في الصحيح من حديث أنس لما كان يوم أحد كسر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كسرت رباعيته وشج في رأسه. When was the day of Uhud? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the disbelievers, they broke his tooth. And he was wounded in his head. وَهُوَ يَسْلُقْ الدَّمْ عَنْ وَجْهِ. He's wiping the blood away from his face. يقول كيف يفلح قوم شجوا نبيهم وكسروا رباعيته وهو يدعوهم إلى الإسلام. How could the people be guided? The Prophet saying. How could the people be guided? And they broke their Prophet's tooth and they cracked his head. And he's calling them to Islam. How could they be guided? فأنزل الله ليس لك من الأمر شيء. You have nothing to do with this matter. Allah guides who He pleases. ليس لك من الأمر شيء. هذه الكلمة استبعاد من النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. This statement, the prophecy is far-fetched that they would be guided. Allah guided all of them. فبعد ذلك قال ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه كأني أنظر إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحكي نبيا من الأنبياء صلوات الله وسلامه عليه ويحكي عن نفسي. Ibn Mas'ud said, it's like I'm looking at the Prophet now. He's talking about one of the Prophets from the Prophets and the Prophet's talking about himself. ضربه قومه حتى أدموه وهو يمسح الدم عن نفسه يقول اللهم اغفر لقومي فإنهم لا يعلمون. هكذا كان يقول أولا كيف يفلح قوم غير كلامه إلى اللهم اغفر لقومي فإنهم لا يعلمون. The Prophet, he was wiping the blood off his face and he said, oh Allah, forgive my people. Really, they don't know any better. قال أهل الإم لما قال اللهم اغفر لقومي, when he made dua for them, this shows he personally forgave them. ثم قال اللهم اغفر لقومي, forgive my people. Stepped off and meant Allah. He said, my people, not those people over there, my people. So that perhaps Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may forgive them. ووجد لهم العذر, he found an excuse for them. He said, perhaps they don't know any better. وفي قصة يوسف فائدة عظيمة إخوتي في الله. In the story of Yusuf, there's a great benefit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains. فقال فلما رجعوا إلى أبيهم قالوا يا أبانا. The brothers of Yusuf, they went and they got grain from Yusuf. They didn't know that this person was Yusuf. And they came back. فقالوا يا أبانا منع منا الكيل فأرسل معنا أخانا نقتل وإنا له لحافظون. The kail, this portion of grain has been prevented for us unless that we come back with our brother. فأرسل معنا أخانا. Send our brother with us. نقتل. We're going to take the grain. We're going to get our portion. وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. And we're going to protect them. But they said that before. وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. They said that before. في يوسف أرسله معنا غدا يرتع ويلعب وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. They said that before. They said send Yusuf with us to play and run around and we're going to protect him. فَقَالَ يَعْقُوبُ هل آمنكم عليه إلا كما آمنتكم على أخيه من قبل. Am I going to trust him with you just like I trusted his brother with you meaning Yusuf? فقال فالله خير حافظا. Allah is the best one for me to put there, the best one to protect him. Meaning I don't trust you all. والله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين. Allah is the best one to protect him and he's more merciful him than me. But that's not what he said the first time. قال إنني يحزنني أن تذهبوا به وأخاف أخاف أن يأكله الذئب. فابتله الله على هذه الكلمة وقع له ما وقع بهذه الكلمة. That's not what he said the first time. The first time he said, it distresses me. It grieves me that you would take Yusuf. And I'm afraid. I'm afraid that a wolf might eat him when you're not aware. And Allah, Ibn Talahu, Allah tested him on that statement. So this time, he's saying, Allahu khayrun hafiz. I don't trust you, but Allah is the best of protectors. Iqwati fillah. Say a good statement, no matter what the situation is. Say a good khayr. Say inshallah khayr. Perhaps Allah was good. Allah yahdik. Mahma kan. Nasr Allah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aid us in our religion. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our hearts sound and ensure and secure. Innahu waliyyu dhalika wal qadir alayh. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wasallam.